Hi everyone, Johnny here for Chaos Cards, and today we have a brand new role-playing game to check out. So let's head down to the top down and I'll tell you all about it. All right, so we have here Salvage Union from Leyline Press. It was a Kickstarter. We've gotten a load of the bits available over on the Chaos Cards online store right now, so do make sure to check it out. We've got this lovely workshop manual, which is essentially the core book that you'll need to play the game. It looks great. It looks like an actual workshop manual, which of course is the whole theme going into this. I don't know too much about it other than what I've read very briefly in the description, so I'm very excited to have a look, see what's inside, and just kind of have a flip through and tell you more about it as we go through. But yeah, this is a thick, hard book there. So Salvage Union is a post-apocalyptic mech tabletop role-playing game. You play as salvager mech pilots who scour the wastelands for salvage in scrap-built mechs. Set in a scarred world ruled by corporations whose denizens live in isolated mega-settlements known as Arcos, the corpos control the vast majority of arable land and resources and have a constant hunger for power and control. As salvagers, you have found a way to live your lives outside the bounds of corpo control, roaming the wastes in a vast mech known as a Union Crawler, which houses your entire community. The scrap you haul back to your Union Crawler is used to support, sustain, and grow your community and craft new mechs for you and your crew. As you explore the wastelands for scrap, you'll encounter wastelanders, raiders, mutants, biotitans, alien meld, and corpo forces all fighting for survival in this hostile landscape. Will you salvage enough scrap for you and your community to survive in the wastes or fall prey to its dangers? So inside, we've got all the rules you need to run and play the game for 3 to 6 players. There is a full scenario, the downing of the Atios. I'll pronounce it like that. But we do also have the other campaigns that you can pick up as well if you wanted to have a few options. A simple D20 variable resolution mechanic powered by the Quest RPG. So the only dice I believe you need to play this game are D20s, which you may have already from D&D and things like that. Rules to craft and customize your mech from 30 different mech chassis and 150 plus different mech systems and modules. Rules to create your salvager pilot from 6 core classes and 5 hybrid classes with 80 plus different abilities and 40 plus pieces of pilot equipment to customize them with. Very nice. A robust NPC list, very helpful, of denizens of the wastelands, including 90 plus unique mech patterns, drones, biotitans, alien meld, wastelanders, vehicles, mutant creatures, and more. Rules for creating your Union Crawler and upkeeping, customizing, and upgrading it during play, as well as creating NPC characters on board who form part of your community. Rules for salvaging and crafting with scrap you find in the wastelands during play. Advice for the game mediator on running Salvage Union, including tools for designing campaigns, creating scenarios, and structuring sessions. Lore on the setting of Salvage Union, and a huge range of gorgeous artwork of the world. I mean, the artwork is already pretty. But look at this. This is a book. Like, if you put this in a garage, someone may accidentally take it out because they think it's a workshop manual, which is great. That is cool. So it took me a second to figure this out, but I'm guessing this is really important things to remember when playing the game, which I think I've seen a few other RPGs do, and obviously board games have references normally on the back of the rule book, but it's nice to have. There's a thing that I need to check. Pushing. Distances. Mech damage, and things like that right here in the front, and it tells you the page number as well, so you can get more about it, which is very nice. Oh, and there's another one here too. And again, creating a character sometimes can be a bit of a difficult process, so having steps here, very handy. Thank you very much. Very, very cool. So I think we've got some like flavor, I'm guessing, here as well, which I think is quite nice. And tells you the content, always very, very cool. All right, we said about the setting already. I'm gonna leave the rest to you to discover, but we've got these beautiful bits of artwork here. I'm assuming this is a Union Crawler? I don't know, but let's have a look and carry on through. And all the pages have this lovely thing. This is not my dirt. This dirt was pre here. It was already made here. But yeah, it seems to play very similar to other role-playing games where you describe the situation and you will use skill checks in order to determine what happens going forward. But the other mechanics and of course the interesting art are things that I definitely want to look out here as well. tells you all about how you create your character, your motto, very nice, always nice to have. I think having a motto actually, or like a catchphrase, definitely adds character there as well, which is very cool. You got hit points, abilities, inventory slots as well, which is very nice. A different pilot classes. So there are six core pilot classes, which I'm assuming are these ones down here. Scout, hauler, engineer, hacker, soldier, and salvager, I guess. But then you've got the hybrid ones, which are like combinations. That's what it appears anyway. I should probably read the book, but you should read the book too by anyone who opens the Curse Cards online store and taking a look, which is very cool as well. That's a lovely legend for the symbols. It's quite cool, but it is very nice. So if I did want to go for more of that kind of sniper path, there's an option to go there for that as well. Or if I wanted to just be full soldier man, I could do that, which is very, very cool as well. So core abilities cost a training point to train. You must have the preceding skill and the core ability tree to train the next ability. So this is the character sheet, which is quite nice as well for your pilot. So engineer, so if I wanted to be an engineer, engineers form an integral component of the Union, the grease that keeps our mech and crawlers trundling across the Great Wastelands. They can take apart and put back together a mech chassis in the blink of an eye and keep their salvage crew operational out in the wastes. Choose an engineer if you want a character with the breadth of engineering and mechanical knowledge who can repair and support you and your allies' mechs. Mount mech parts significantly faster and allow you to craft mech parts in the field. Very cool. So you've got different abilities here that I guess you get down a tree, and they cost different points, which again, I'm guessing, I haven't read the rules thoroughly, but I'm guessing this is the amount of like XP, TP, that it costs for you to get these different abilities in a nice tree. And then you've got advanced abilities and legendary abilities as well, and the different hybrid classes that it says here as well. Abilities like this are always quite nice, and it's nice to have a tree too, which you can follow down as well. And then you have another tree here too, which is quite cool. So you've got lots of different options, which is very interesting. Oh, too many options. So many options. You got a hacker here as well. It's definitely something where I'd like to make a character and just go through the steps of the process, which you can do, obviously, by following the steps there and then following the steps on the other page as well. By going through too. But it's nice to see that there are so many different options. You've got the hauler as well. You've got your salvager. That's great. Scout there too. Soldier, of course, as well. Custom missile launcher, very nice. Cyborg, very cool. Fabricator, so you're starting to get into these, are these the hybrid ones now? Ranger, yeah. Which are very nice here too. Smuggler, of course, as well. Union rep. Pilot equipment at different tech levels. Got, yeah, so first aid kits, torch, etc. Healing biofoam, very nice. I like these bits of flavor. They're very cool. I assume they're something available in different books and stuff. So you got backgrounds here as well, and the call sign, that's quite a nice thing. And you can also roll for your keepsake, your motto, your appearance table, your AI personality table. Oh. Mech workshop, so this is making your mech. So gain scrap, you start with 20 tech, 1 scrap. You will use this scrap to craft your first mech. This is built out of a tech 1 mech chassis and any number of tech 1 systems and modules installed on the mech chassis. Very cool. So it tells you all the different stats as well for your mech as you'll go about, and you've got a mech sheet here as well, which is going to be very handy going forwards there too. So you've got a mule, very nice, and they've got hauler pattern, crusher pattern, Avantis pattern as well here too. So you've got a mule, you've got a Mazona, a scrapper, a spectrum, thresher, forge, gopher, hussar, Jackhammer, Kraken, Magpie, Mirable, there's so many mechs, Atlas, Brawler, Little Sestra, very nice, I'm a big fan of Orphan Black, Mantis, Photon, Solo, Terra, Aegis, Colossus, wow, Console, yep, Drop Bear, Vorpal, Carrier, Eidolon, Eidolon, Neurophage, Iron, look at that huge thing, Leviathan, Shaitan, look at that, beautiful. And again, there's probably different aspects of these that you get and things like that, and different options you have at different levels here too that I'm not going into, but it just shows you the breadth and depth of options that you have in this game as well. I can imagine playing this so many different times for so many different years and creating different mechs, different people, adding on to the mechs, making them more powerful and better and cooler throughout the entire history of whatever campaign I'm playing. Eggs Mayhem, I don't know what that does, but it sounds cool. So many different things that you can add on to your mechs and your people as well, which is very cool here too. Quirks of your mechs, you can have them have flashing RGB lights like every streamer everywhere. You've got Union Crawler. Okay, so this is your main Union Crawler that you'll have there too. So is that, is there like a, it's, so you've got, I want to see a big picture of a Union Crawler with a thing. I'm assuming the other one is there too. But it's the kind of your home, your place that you will go back to, you'll improve and things like that as well, which I think is quite nice. And I can imagine if I was running a campaign, that would be an end game where someone like tries to take control of your crawler or destroy it or something. So you got the core rules. So core rules. When a player declares an action within the game that has an uncertain, risky, or potentially interesting outcome, they roll a 20-sided die. So, and then depending on that roll, you do it, basically, which is quite nice. So you can push though, you can push mechs. There's different things like heat as well. Group checks, group initiative, movement distance, actions on your turn as well, of course, very important. Free actions, short actions, long actions, which is quite nice as well. Activating a mech, attacks, improvised damage, death blow, mech damage, critical damage for your mech, pilot damage. So many different things here. Salvaging, very important as well, how you do that. So salvaging in the Wastelands usually fits into some of the following different archetypes, which are very handy, putting them into different archetypes. So it makes it easier to write that on sheets and things like that as well. And you've got scrap tables here as well, which is very handy for a DM to kind of show off as well. Salvaging abilities as well. So all pilots have the following abilities, which is very cool too. Mediator advice as well. Advice as well is always great in any of these books for how to run the game, especially when there's, because there's so many different games, and giving advice on how to run these specific kind of games, like how much exploration to do, how many different setbacks you should be doing, how many attacks and combat should I do. So yeah, it's interesting to have this GM section as well, and advice on how to create a campaign, which I think is always very nice when it's a new game and you're like, oh, I want to make a region, but how many settlements do I put in? What different factions do I have? Where do I put big scrap points? I don't know. So yeah, it's very nice to have that all in here as well. Denizens of the Wastelands, so more information on the NPCs, which is again super helpful here as well. Reactions, morale, retreating. You've got encounter tables, which are always very nice. I'm a big fan of encounter tables here too, for different bits of the waste, which is very cool. Bio titans and having bits of art for them as well, which is very, very cool as well. So you got Scylla, Typhon, Chrysalis, Phantom, Electrophorus, Tyrant, Meld. So you got the aliens, Behemoth, vehicles are here as well, drones, you got creatures, people. Also, I will say, I'm a big fan of how small these kind of stat blocks are. It's very handy. Squads as well. Downing of the Atco. So this is the scenario as well. So we're going to briefly go over this. I'm not going to go too in-depth into it. Not that I have been really in the rest of the book either. But it's nice to have all different kind of basic maps here as well, and different arts and specific NPC blocks as well. Back of the book, keywords and traits, very important. I'm a big fan of them here as well. Just nice and easy to find when you need them, which is very, very handy. There is one, a glossary, of course, too. Very important there as well. And so what do we have in the back? Let's see. Aha, tables. I'm a big fan of tables. So you got all of the different tables here that you you may need. Critical injuries, of course, very important here as well. And yeah, that is Salvage Union. So overall, and a brief look, it's not an in-depth look at all, but the role-playing aspects and like the combat aspects seem very easy to get into. The character creation seems relatively easy to get into as well. All of that stuff seems relatively easy to get into, but there is a depth and breadth of options here, which I think is going to be really nice. It could be overwhelming because there's a lot of different options, but I think as you narrow down and maybe make choices very quickly about what you want to do, where you want to go, who you want to be, I think that could be really interesting. But I think having more choices, but an easy game overall, I think is really nice. And especially for like a session one or a session zero, when you're kind of getting and easing into a game, I think it's really cool. And this whole aesthetic, I think is really nice. And as a DM and a GM as well, I think this is very, it seems very nice and light on the GM side, which is very important too, I would say, because the GM is one of the players. But in terms of making everything and doing everything, all the factions, things like that, it seems relatively straightforward, which I think is quite nice as well. But the amount of options that players have for when making their mechs and making their pilots, I think is really, really cool, and can make for some very interesting characters with some very diverse skills, which I think is going to be quite cool too. So do make sure to check out Salvage Union, available over on the Chaos Cards online store. We've got some of the other expansions as well. We've got the specific D20s too, but don't forget that you can always use any D20s. We have a load available over on the Chaos Cards online store as well. Even if you're just picking it up for this book, this thick book, it's very nice. The art is very cool as well. And Leyline Press too. It seemed lovely. So thank you for watching this video. I've been Johnny for Chaos Cards, and I'll see you next time.